Now we start making expressions. That's the power of Maya particles. That's where you can control basically everything. So let's just make a simple function here. Okay, the difference, there's a runtime before dynamics and there's creation. Runtime after dynamics is rarely used, so I'll concentrate on those two. Creation means, for example, okay, and then you see that you have the object, we have particle shape, or we have radius pp here. It's already put, you know, expression, you have a beginning already here. So if you copy that, copy, and then paste into your expression editor, and then say equal, at the creations we say particle shape pp, radius pp equal, and then we say random. Random command is rand, and then parenthesis, what's that, parenthesis, right? Yeah. And then between, let's say, point one and point five, all right? And then close parentheses, and then don't forget semicolon. At the end, create, let's see what happens. They come out, they've been created different sizes from point one to point five. Expression editor is, you can go, you see the, your field here, right click, and you got creation expression. All right, so we're going back to expression editor. Before I learned expressions, I used to cheat by going to, that's another great website, highend3d.com. Register there, it's free. Lots of freebies. Creative Crash. Yeah. Oh, Ruin, something added for cinema. Okay, choose software, and we go Maya. And then Maya sections, we go to free downloads. And here we have all kind of, you know, we have 3D models, of course, and they have textures, and they have rigs, for example. You probably got some rigs from there. I saw, yeah. And you got scripts or plugins. Yeah, come on. What's going on? And then, okay. So in the plugins, in the, you have a paint, like paint effects brush, you have a, what's that? Called scripts. Okay, Maya character, no, I want scripts. And then you have here for effects, where in our effect dynamics, right? So we have all kind of dynamics scripts. So you can all check it out. And once you downloaded it, what I would do, I would go and check, open the expression editor. And for example, you have a, you know, you know what's your particle shape, what's your particle name. You can, this is by default, call it particle shape one, but if in the script there's a different name, you just rename it and see what happens. So all you need to know is have, you know, the difference between before dynamics creation and know how to open it in the expression editor, and then you start tweaking it. And you can see what's, you know, what people wrote. So let's go runtime expression, and let's say, so radius pp will be, let's do RGB. Let's do RGB pp. So if we start creation, we say RGB pp equal, also random, one, since R. It's vector, so we have to put, what do you call it? less than, and then random, and then you put your number, which will be random, or will be like one, what's that R? Little. And then, yeah, zero. Let's make them red when they born. Let's make them born red. Edit. See what happens. They're all red. But if we want them to flick for some reason during their lifetime, and we want to do that through expressions, so close. So we go RGBPP, and then runtime before dynamics. And we say random. Random number from 0 to 1. And same here. Same for blue color. Create. So after they migrated, the expressions run on and they're still being affected.
Can you explain? I'm still a little bit confused about the difference between runtime before dynamics, after
dynamics. That's the rarely used. I don't really. Okay. That's a new thing in my 11, so I gotta check it. I haven't seen like expression that has this after dynamics. So the difference in creation and before dynamics, that's what you should pay attention to. Mm-hmm. All right. So for example, yeah, exactly. Very good. And now let's do the radius expression and then put before dynamics and let's say, okay, we have radius here. Copy that. Not really. We just can, okay, before dynamics and then radius. Copy, paste. Equal time. See what happens. Ooh, too much time. Now, let's scale it down a bit. So it will be time multiply 0.1. So till they grow till they, you know, all the time. Time which frame, so they will. All right. So it's re-evaluates every single frame, runtime before dynamics. All right. Goals. Let's do goals. Particle goals. Oh, collision events. That's a great thing. Let's delete all that thing, make a new one.